If this levy fails for a fourth time, what does this mean for our kids? News 6's Karen Johnson visited other districts nearby that have been there before.
We went to Jefferson Township schools, which are in fiscal emergency right now, as well as Springfield City schools, which got out of fiscal emergency about a year ago. And these schools are very different than Little Miami, so we're not comparing apples to apples here. But from talking to folks in those districts, I found out what could happen if Tuesday's levy fails. Kiera Cole and her sister Dinah wait patiently for their mother to come pick them up. They live a mile and a half away from Springfield High School, but can't ride the bus because the district is on limited bus service, even though it's been out of fiscal emergency for a year. Cuts that were implemented when the state took over in 2005 have become permanent.
When the state comes in at that point, you virtually have to consider that everything is on the table because they have that kind of power. Everything in that school system is on the table.
Springfield also cut staff by 25%, reduced academic programs, increased class size, and sold some of its property. As a result, more than 500 students left the district one year.
I do have a few friends who have gone to like Shawnee because of fear of sports being cut and stuff.
Sports weren't cut, but athletes continue to pay to play. Other districts say when the state comes in, it does not mean local board members are forced out, a big misconception around Little Miami.
No, that's not the case. And it's almost like there's another layer of management above the local board of education that now oversees the board of education.
Local leaders still have the power to decide what goes and what stays, but if they hit a wall, that's when the state will make the decision for them.
At the end of the day, the state of Ohio could say, what you can afford is only the most minimal program, and that's all you will be able to offer to the students of this district.
Parents we talked to say they don't feel the quality of their kids' education was greatly affected.
I've had four to graduate from college. I got two in college, one going to UC, one going to Rice State.
Although folks admit it was trying times for the community, when all said and done, they agree their schools are in a better place now.
Absolutely.
Springfield School says it's now living within its means. And I also talked to the Ohio Department of Education, and it told me every situation is different. Whatever